Tabernacle of Prayer. If my people, which are called by my name, shall humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then will I hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land. Father God, as we come before your throne of grace and of mercy, we enter into the outer court, the brazen altar, the cross, where you have provided your salvation according to Romans 8, 9, and 10. Thank you, Father, that at the cross, healing is available according to Isaiah 53, 4 through 5. Thank you for the redemption of reversing the curse according to Galatians 3, 13. Thank you for a new nature according to Ephesians 4, 24. And we thank you that at the cross, the provision has been made according to Philippians 4, 19. Thank you, Father, as we continue in the outer court, we go to the lever for the washing, for the cleansing, for the preparation. We repent now from any known sin according to Psalm 51, and we offer our body according to your word in Romans 12, 1, as a living sacrifice, as well as our mind according to Luke 10, 27. Thank you for the fruit of the Spirit that is flowing through our lives now because of the Holy Spirit that lives on the inside of us, according to Galatians 5, 22 to 23. Thank you, Father, that we have been washed, we have been cleansed in the outer court, at the brazen altar, and at the lever. And now, Father, we enter into the holy place where the candlestick abides, which is the presence of the Holy Spirit. Thank you that according to Isaiah 11 and 2, that the seven spirits of the Lord rest upon us now. The Spirit of the Lord, the Spirit of wisdom, the Spirit of understanding, the Spirit of counsel, the Spirit of might, the Spirit of knowledge, and the Spirit of the fear of the Lord. And as we continue in this place, we thank you for the gifts of the Spirit, according to 1 Corinthians 12, 8 through 10. And it is because of these gifts that it enables us to do your will. Thank you, Father, for the table of showbread that's in the holy place, which is your word. So as we come before you now, Father, asking for fresh revelation of your word. Thank you, Father, that in your presence is the altar of incense, and that is a place of true divine worship. And as we worship you in spirit and in truth. We worship El Shaddai. We worship Elohim. We worship El Elyon. We worship Jehovah Shammah. We worship Jehovah Rapha. We worship Jehovah Sitkanu. We worship Jehovah Tesur. We worship Jehovah Emkadesh. We worship Jehovah Jireh. We worship the one and only true and living God in the tabernacle of prayer. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father, that it is out of our true worship we're now able to enter into the Holy of Holies, the mercy seat the ark of intercession. Hallelujah, Father. And it is in this place that we pray for those that are in authority, whether spiritually, civilly, in our families, in our workplaces, in our places of worship. We pray for our pastors. We pray for our fellow members in the body of Christ. We pray for the apostles and the prophets and the evangelists and the pastors and the teachers. We pray for the missionaries, Lord God. We pray for the bishops, Lord God. We pray for the deacons, Lord God. We pray for all those who have come into the knowledge and have accepted, Lord God, your son Jesus as their Lord and as their Savior. We pray, Father, for the youngest to the eldest, for those near and for those far. We pray for them now, Father, that you will strengthen them. We pray now that they will stand in righteousness and holiness. We pray now, Father, for our leaders in government, Father, those leaders in our workplaces, even those leaders in our communities, in our neighborhoods, Father. We pray for our cities, we pray for our nation, we pray for our world. Father, I thank you that as we have entered into this place of intercession, standing in the gap, Jesus, I thank you for sitting at the right hand of the Father, making intercession even for us now. Thank you that in you every need is met, for there is no lack in you, but there's more than enough.